That's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
You see, God don't work on your time and my time. He works on his own time.
Amen.
All you got to do is wait on him. Look at somebody and say, wait on your miracle.
Wait on your miracle.
Look at him again and say, your miracle is already here.
Your miracle is already here.
All you got to do is just say, I claim my miracle is right here.
I claim my miracle right here.
And right now.
Right now.
Galilee, you know what I mean? That was his neighborhood. And down in Cana and Capernaum. And while he was down in this region, the Bible said he went into a household. And in this household, everybody got word that Jesus was in the house. Is Jesus in the house?
Amen.
I said, is Jesus in the house?
Amen.
Amen. Somebody. He said, wherever two or three gather together, in my name, there am I. A miracle, and my faith is after it. All I got to do is believe him and take him at his word.
Amen.
The Bible said that the whole house was packed. Folks were everywhere, all in the doorway, all around the window. There was everybody packing. He was preaching and teaching to the Pharisees and the scribes, and all those that had packed the house. Jesus can back a house. Somebody said, if he can perform a miracle,
he can back a house.
He can back a
house.
Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
I ain't talking about one of the, you know, songwriters of the world who can pack a house and charge you $150. Come on, somebody. Jesus was just performing miracles and he packed the house. Come on, somebody. The Bible said there was one that was born crippled and he was a paraplegic. He couldn't move, he couldn't walk, he couldn't do nothing on his own. And everywhere he had to go, somebody had to carry him. Come on, somebody. There's a lot of folks in the church today that are spiritually paralyzed and they can't go nowhere, but they always want somebody to carry them. Bible said those who carried him tried to get in the front door. It was jammed up. They went around the back door. It was jammed up. They looked through the window. It was jammed up. They said, ain't but one way to get in this place. We're going to have to go through the roof. Come on, somebody. They got him up on the roof. I can see the guy on the back. I can see Jesus in the midst teaching all those that were listening. What's going on here? They come and touch the roof of God. You didn't call no roofer, did you? Come on, y'all. You see, I'm the only one that thinks like that. I'm trying to get in the mind of Christ. Come on, man. I'm trying to think like he thought. Amen. That he was looking up. And all of a sudden, they moved all the things away. All that was sitting on top of the roof. And out of nowhere, heck of this man, come on somebody, that couldn't get in the front door. Couldn't get in the back door. Couldn't get through the window. But Jesus looked up and here he comes out of the sea. On a pallet. And let him down. Come on, somebody. And I can see the man looking at the sea. Jesus looking down at the man. Come on. You know that ain't getting ready to happen right now. Christ is getting ready to perform a miracle. this thing right up here. Maybe it ain't as good as you as it is to me, amen. But I get excited when Jesus gives me to heal somebody. Can you imagine this man coming down, they laying him on the pallet, and Jesus looked at him, come on somebody, and everybody else looking at him. You always have that group, it's what they call antics. They roll their eyes, they throw their head back, they suck the teeth. Come on somebody, they throw their nose up. They get mad and cough their lungs. Looking like Tupac Shakur. Come on somebody, looking like UMS. Come on, that's what I'm talking about. Getting mad in a minute, jump back like Jack Bill. They want to fight everybody in town. Come on somebody. And this man is getting ready to perform a miracle. And yet they want to condemn him. You need a miracle? Touch somebody by the hand and say, I need a miracle. It doesn't matter whether it's in the spiritual realm, the physical realm, the financial realm. Come on, somebody. It doesn't matter whether it's in the ecclesiastic realm. Whatever you need from God, God will supply your needs. Somebody say amen. The Bible said when Jesus looked on this man that was laying on the pad, he said, my son, thy sins are forgiven thee. That's when that real demons that was supposed to have been cast out, the real spirits that cast out, they came back in the house. Y'all with me on this? See, I was talking about how spirits walk through dry places, looking for a place to find, looking to settle down. Come on, somebody. And when they can't find a place, they run back up where they used to be. Amen. Them spirits are sitting up there watching Jesus. And when he said, who is this? Who do you think he is that can forgive a sin? By what authority do you have this? And the Bible said Jesus discerned. He picked up in the spirit. He picked up in his anointing. He picked up in the power of God. And they was talking about his miracle. He said, what is it easy for me to say, pick up thy bed and walk, or to say thy sins are forgiven? Come on. He said, but that you might know that the Son of Man has power on earth. Has power to heal. I can see the one that came through. I love his fire. But you got to be in the spiritual realm to see this. Picked up his little bed and had him on, said, get out of my way. Let me know I'm on the right. Let me know I'm preaching the right thing.